They're an icon of the plains. Pronghorn antelopes still roam the grasslands of West Texas, but in the last 3 years, pronghorn populations have plummeted.
Our biologists were noticing huge declines in the Marfa area. They started calling landowners, and then they started, oh yeah, we saw 5 dead here, 4 dead there.
And we blamed a lot of that on the drought, but we began to get rains and watch the antelope continue to decline, and then we knew we had a problem.
One clue may be a tiny stomach worm showing up in record numbers in West Texas pronghorn.
One blood worm can take as much as 1/10 of a cc of blood a day. But if you have thousands of these worms in your stomach, then obviously you become anemic, you're weakened, you're not going to evade predators and cold spells and heat spells like you would if you were a more healthy animal.
To investigate the case, scientists are turning to area landowners and hunters for help.
I think the pronghorn antelope is beautiful. I'm not going to see those in Florida.
I'm ready.
You're ready?
Yep.
And once the animal is harvested, and we will basically be doing a necropsy on the animal and extracting various samples from that animal.
This is a kidney.
Bucks may be hunted for 9 days by permit only. This narrow hunting window provides the perfect opportunity for collecting tissue samples for analysis.
It sounds counterintuitive that someone that actually hunts these animals also wants to protect their well-being. Hunters are very much in favor of conservation to help both not only the animal but the habitat in which the animal lives.
The hunters and the landowners have played a huge role. We basically couldn't do any of this research without them.
From the field, the samples go to the lab for analysis.
Great smell.
As scientists search for answers, folks in West Texas rally to preserve this true native Texan.
A lot of the ranchers, hunters, wildlife enthusiasts view pronghorn is that it's an icon of the West, a flagship for grasslands.
They've been part of the landscape before we were here. Hopefully they'll be here after we're gone. And as stewards of the land here, I just can't sit by and not try to do something.